At Arizona State University, the Department of Research Computing's primary goal is to support researchers. When I took the role as Director of Research Computing, I inherited multiple disparate silos of data related to research. So the primary benefit of aggregating the disparate silos of data we have is now we have a single source that we can use as a collaborative tool to mine non-obvious relationship analysis from. Arizona State University's policy has been to maintain open big data. So we maintain data that essentially we share out in the forms of documents and file types with multiple other institutions. The data types that we needed to bring in were specifically epidemiology studies, x-rays, x-ray crystallography, DNA, genome samples, gene samples, and although that sounds like a small sampling of data, that is, we're talking about 75 different types of files and data types just in that workload. One of the things that makes Hadoop a great candidate for this type of data is we didn't require many of the traditional ETL mechanisms. We were able to mount up and move data onto these nodes and then use the tools to manipulate them. Ideally, for precision medicine, we gather as many points as we possibly can. It's certainly one of the components we like about the current Hadoop framework is that it has the flexibility to ingest data types that we didn't know existed when we first stood up the platform. A good example of that is sensor data, whether it be from Fitbit or the Google glucose contact lens or any other thing that has not yet been invented. And I think the Hadoop platform in itself allows us to ask questions that we know today, but also be ready to ask questions that we haven't even thought of yet. Hortonworks has the unique positioning to have remained open source, and myself as a former NSF panel reviewer, there's an emphasis on open source software. So it makes us it makes Hortonworks a good choice for us because of that feature. Apache Spark seems to be the way that most of our particular MapReduce jobs, or our legacy MapReduce jobs, are now going. We have tumor simulators that used to run as long as 600 hours that now run somewhere in the realm of 30 minutes. So it's my belief that Hortonworks support is the best in the industry because that's all they sell. They're not essentially selling software and then bolting support on top of it. They're giving you open source software and then they're charging you for support. So that support you pay for has to be a good product. And what they've proven so far at Arizona State University is it's worth what we pay for because we rely on it heavily for many of our research initiatives. So we're very confident that the research we're doing and the collaborative efforts will lead to new inroads in pharmacogenomics, the aggregation of data from multiple institutions and multiple studies, and then the ability to crunch and run multiple simulations much faster than we used to will lead us to these discoveries sooner.